This is part two of the my SummerSlam prediction. And on the last video I pretty much covered almost every match. So let me finish off for the next couple of matches that I have. So let's get started. So one of the matches that I didn't mention, you got the New Day versus Primetime Players versus Luchador Dragons versus Los Matadors, and a Fatal 4-Way tag team match with a tag team championships, which I found out now has been moved to the pre-show. Normally, I never talk about the pre-show. I could care less about the pre-show. The only reason I'm talking about the pre-show here is because the match got moved. It was on the main card, but then because matches kept getting added on, they moved it to the pre-show. And for this match, I can see the Primetime Players retaining the tag team titles, even though I wouldn't mind seeing Luchador Dragons win the tag team titles. I could clearly see the Primetime Players retaining the tag team titles here at SummerSlam. I can't see them losing the tag team titles this early, although it is possible that they can lose the tag team titles this early. But most likely, the Primetime Players should be able to prevail, and they should be able to retain their tag team titles at SummerSlam. Because this would be a major step for them. And the only two really big interesting teams in this match is the Primetime Players and Luchador Dragons and somewhat of New Day. But Los Matadores is really not all that great as a team. I mean, they try. I'm not saying that they're the worst. They try. But they're just not that good to be tag team champions. It's obvious. It's extremely obvious. I can see why they've never been put as tag team champions. But for this match, I can see the Primetime Players retaining the tag team championship. I think most likely the Primetime Players are going to retain the tag team championship. Next match, you got John Cena versus Seth Rollins for the US Championship. No. Excuse me. John Cena versus Seth Rollins, winner take all. Whoever wins will not only have the WWE World Heavyweight Championship, but will also hold the United States Championship. This is a big match. And honestly, because it's so big, I'm going to have to go with John Cena. And here's the thing. It's not because I want John Cena to win, but I know how the WWE creative team is. If you think about it, just about every time it's the first time ever for John Cena, he's always won it. When Cena was in his first steel cage match, he won it. When he went against Edge in 2006, when Cena was in his first ladder match in 2006 against Edge, he won it. When Cena was in his first Money in the Bank match, he won it. Every time it's like a first time ever for Cena, he always seems to win. And for this match, I'm just gonna simply go with John Cena. Because I mean, Seth Rollins has been WWE World Heavyweight Champion for a while, and I definitely can't see them giving him, not only have him retain his title, but also give him the United States Championship. I can't see them doing that. Even though it would be very shocking if they did, by the way how WWE is, most likely they're going to give this to John Cena. There's no doubt about it. Even though a lot of people did not want to see him beat Ric Flair's record, it's on note that he's going to end up tying Ric Flair's record because that's just how WWE is going. I don't know why they act like, I felt like when Seth Rollins was done rivaling with Brock Lesnar, that it was a little thing going on between Seth Rollins and Cesaro. And I felt like they could have went in that direction They could have went in a direction where they should have had Cesaro versus Seth Rollins at SummerSlam. I wouldn't have mind seeing that because I know that that would be one heck of a match. And I'm not saying this match would disappoint because Cena's already proven in a lot of his matches that he can prevail. I'm not saying this match would disappoint. But what I am saying is that in this match, most likely, I think Cena's going to come out on top. I can't see it going any other way because of how the WWE creative team is, specifically Vince McMahon. But, I have nothing against John Cena. And it's not that I just love John Cena. But for this match, I can definitely see John Cena retaining his US title and winning WWE World Heavyweight Championship. Because for one thing, it's not like Seth Rollins got anybody to help him anymore like he used to. That's long and gone now. And it's just completely different. So for this match, I'm gonna have to go with John Cena. I think Seth Rollins is gonna give a heck of a fight, but I'm gonna have to go with John Cena. And I guess that leaves me with the last match because pretty much I've went over all the other matches that are on the card. Oh no, I didn't. There's one match I'm missing. And that's just simply because I don't really care about it that much. Neville and Stephen Amell versus King Barrett and Stardust. In this match, I honestly don't care who wins. It's just that simple. Of course, because Stephen Amell is like a star, a Hollywood star, they're probably gonna have him and Neville end up winning. Most likely, I believe that Neville and Stephen Amell are gonna win as a team. I can't see them making it as an embarrassing thing where Stardust and King Barrett win, but I really could care less about this because it wasn't that much of a build up, and it was really stupid in my opinion. And I'm not criticizing or anything like that, but I just honestly could care less about who wins this match because it's not really that all that interesting to me. Oh yeah, there is another match that I did not mention. This will be the last match I mentioned before the main event. So the next match is family versus family. I forgot to mention this. I apologize. I thought I was nearly done. I'm not done because there's a lot of matches on this card. So I just mentioned about, Stephen Amell match like that. I think Neville and Stephen Amell is going to win. So we got the family versus family match. Now this match is interesting because, I want to go with Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose, but at the same time, you never know. Because if you think about it, Dean Ambrose has only won one pay-per-view this whole year, and that was at Extreme Rules when he went against Luke Harper. And other than that, he's been losing at pay-per-views. And it's the same thing for Roman Reigns. Roman Reigns won the Royal Rumble, won at Fastlane, then he lost at WrestleMania. Then he lost it, but then he won at Extreme Rules, which was a good thing. But then that's when other things happen with Roman Reigns. And, this match is really interesting. I would love to see how this match is going to turn out. I think both teams are going to give it a really good match. I think it's going to be kind of how it was back when you had the full team of the Wyatt family, when you had the full team of the when you had the full team of the Shield, but except this time it's only half. So this match is going to be really interesting in my opinion. I would love to see how this is going to turn out. And Luke Harper can do a lot of amazing tricks. And Bray Wyatt has already owned the victory over Dean Ambrose and Roman Reigns respectively. So I would love to see Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose go out on top. I would love to see them win this match, especially to give Roman Reigns a pay-per-view win since he hasn't won a pay-per-view in a while, and since Dean Ambrose hasn't won a pay-per-view in a while. So this match is going to be pretty interesting, family versus family. I'm going to have to go with Roman Reigns and Dean Ambrose, but then again, you never know with the way how the creative team is. And there's going to be one more part, and this last part is going to talk about this last part of the SummerSlam edition is going to talk about the final match of the night. So stay tuned.